to understand me and to find out and have fun and play and explore who I am and how I respond to things. It's only when I've read and I've written that I've come to a place where I go, yep, I'm ready now to share. And a lot of stuff I just enjoy to play with and everything. But it's about my exploration of me rather than doing it for a specific show or an exhibition. It's my journey, personal journey.
That's what most artists
call. Oh, is it?
I used to run a gallery. Self-absorbed and no, that's a good thing. We have to have people like that.
Yes.
I mean, I'm black and white. Yes. I need people who are self-absorbed and who will go that further into themselves to express. And I mean, I couldn't take photos. I'd be too impatient. It wouldn't have the light. I just couldn't stand waiting around. But I appreciate when a true artist does. And that's why it's beautiful when the person goes that one step further.
So how long between the germ of an idea and the fruition, do you think, is it? There is no time frame, I suppose. It just happens.
Well, I remember the first exhibition I had, I actually had no idea about exhibiting. I hadn't studied art, I hadn't been to college, I hadn't had any training. But I remember I was in a swimming pool and I saw this vortex happening and I wanted to take a photograph of it. And that was my first body of work. Some of you may have seen that at the QCP. And I was so excited, but I didn't have the equipment. I didn't have an underwater camera. So I bought one of those little $20 ones from the chemist, and that was hopeless. So I had to wait another year before I could borrow somebody's camera to have a go at this pool. It's cold. I had to wait until the next summer. And then I had to wait till the next summer because I didn't realise the light needed to be really high. I couldn't do it in winter with a wetsuit. It had to be a really strong light. So, but I knew, I had in my belly this excitement that I knew that these photographs were going to be amazing, that they connected me with something which was unseen. And that was, so 2 years I waited just to see that idea become practical.
Yeah.
And for this one, I mean, I didn't have the idea evolved. I wasn't so excited.
Didn't come to good information.
No, no.
You didn't hop in the car.
No, I was actually carrying my work in the back of my car because I'm not a fan of flying, so I do a lot of driving and do a lot of food shopping and make meals for the crew back home and get the washing organised. Out I go. And I stop, and I've always done that, but I was always only ever allowed 2 or 3 stops on a trip from here to Armidale because otherwise I'd be stopping all the time. When I'm on my own, I can please myself when I stop, and I just took photographs, and this sort of evolved.
Are you working on your next exhibition?
I am.
That's
the plan. I wanted to, for a long time, work with abstract images, and that's really hard, really, really hard. Because I don't want my images to look like just colour, like you get from a Freedom Furniture photo, you know, something that goes with the house or the lounge room. I want to be able to capture the essence of the environment, that real unseen quality of the divine nature of the environment, you know, get that, I can't even put it into words, but I want to be able to capture it through my lens. And I'm so over camera movement where people just pan down the trees with grass coming up. That's, for me, I'm not looking at doing that sort of thing. I'm actually trying to use, I'm using neutral density filters to increase the time so that I'm hoping that what I see and what I feel is actually transposed in the images. And I want to also incorporate that with ritual and like the sacredness and how people in different countries relate to the land and how I relate to the land and my own ritual practice. practice of meditation and yoga in the landscape, and I've just started doing that without any success, a little bit of success, but I've still got that same feeling in my belly, that excitement that I know that needs to be explored, and I'm travelling to the outback Lake Eyre for 3 weeks with my husband leaving next week when we're doing the Kimberleys. But I also need to connect with my own environment, which is what I said before. I have a beautiful block of land in my studio, and it's near the Glasshouse Mountains, and that's a really beautiful area. So I mustn't ever forget that's really important to explore with this abstract work that I'm doing. But that's just for me, my own exploration. I want to see whether I can develop that essence of the land and transpose it onto the landscape in a non-identifiable way. So that's the boundary I'm pushing at the moment. And I don't know how it's going to go. It doesn't matter.
It's good to hear that it feels real. It's done to feel, you know, all you do now, and you know that we're not doing it as well, because I'm living in terms of my houses forever, but I haven't thought.
Just push your ideas a little bit further. If it doesn't tell you something about yourself, I'd suggest pushing the idea further. Work out how you can take a photograph that actually does make you question something about yourself.
Maybe
analyze why. I wouldn't be analysing anything to start with. Personally, I think you just need to come from not here. I think we can get here in a way a lot more. I personally, and from experience of artists, I think that, I mean, it's really important to analyse after the fact and to work through concepts and to study and learn about other artists. But I also think that when you're there, when you've got your camera, you need to stop thinking. You need to start feeling and observing, looking for fine details. Then thinking, well, what's next? What's unseen? You know, beer cans, rubbish. What does that indicate? Lack of respect, lack of tidiness, lack of care. And then I create a tension here by having my great uncle and aunt really proud of their really modest home and beautiful flowers. So it's about that dichotomy and tension of contradictions which help us sort of question things.
Do you ever get the feeling after you develop your ideas like every year and say, gee, I've got to go back and take this from a different angle, or I wish I'd taken this photo from this position to better illustrate what I now think is the
I've taken a photograph of the one at the top left there, 335, on my way home from Melbourne last time. That's at Castlemaine, and I went past the house and I couldn't believe that it had changed so much. That had been sold, and it was for sale, and the little ramp had gone, and they painted the different colours, and the chairs were different. They actually had a big floral couch, and I stopped and took. There was nobody home. I knocked. There was no one home. I took a photograph of them from the front gate. But that changed. I never thought. Oh, I wish I'd gone back and got a bit of sun rose or anything. That's pointless. For me, it's pointless. For you, for your work, it might be really important. Because that's part of your learning, and you might have gone. You might be working on light, so you might learn from what's on the screen and think, oh, that was a really poor choice of time for me to take that. I really needed warm light, or this would work really well with grey sky and lots of contrast with black and white. I'm going to do that next time.
Yeah.
But that's not what I'm about. For me, I'm a lot more spontaneous, and like I said, that's why I needed notes, because I can go at tangents. And I think that the stillness in my life and that inner stillness allows me to do that. Although I'm a bit outwardly scattered, there's a sense of clarity which helps guide me to follow what I need to follow so that I can